Okay guys, so here's the tools required to complete the job. You're going to need an adjustable crescent wrench, a 7mm socket. In this case, I'm borrowing a friend's little thumb ratchet. This is actually not a bad idea to keep around, but if you do have a little 7mm ratchet drive, you can get away with that as well. Just be mindful that you can apply way more torque than you need to using that versus a little thumb ratchet, and the nozzle of your choice to swap out. Okay, here's your quick primer on how all metal hot ends work, seal, and potential issues you can run into. This right here is the heat break. You'll notice it has this very thin area right here, and we definitely need to be mindful of that when we're working on the hot end, because this right here is very fragile and it's very easy to either bend or break the hot end at that point, and that can cause a whole heck of a lot of issues. So whenever you're working on the hot end, take your time, be careful. Besides the fact that it's going to be hot, that's your biggest fear right there. Another thing to keep in mind is the way that these hot ends seal. If there's any gap, and I'm exaggerating it here for the camera, between the heat break and the nozzle, you will have plastic oozing all over the place, which becomes a giant fiasco to deal with later. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to get the bottom of the heat break and the top of the nozzle to gently press together to form a seal. Both these surfaces are very flat and smooth, so when they push up against each other, they form a good enough seal that plastic can go through without oozing all over the place. So even just an ever so slight gap is all it takes for plastic to ooze out. You gotta remember, for it to come out of a tiny nozzle, there's a lot of pressure inside there. Okay, so the first step in changing out the nozzle on the printer is we need to get rid of the filament that's already in the system. So to do that, let's jump down to the control screen and get started. All right, we're up to temp, so we can confirm. And it's pulling it out. Okay, strictly for the purposes of making it easier for you guys to see what's going on here, I have removed the cooling fan assembly here. I've also removed the side shield as well, so you get a better view of what's going on. During normal nozzle changes though, removing those is not necessary. So we're gonna keep the assembly hot, so that way if there's any plastic that's oozed into the threads, that won't become an issue. So what we can do is we can take our adjustable crescent wrench here and we can just carefully slide it onto the heat block. We might need to adjust it a little bit. Like so. This is just to brace it so we don't damage the throat. And then we can take our little wrench assembly and we can just gently unscrew it. Now we can take our replacement nozzle, in this case a MicroSwiss 0.4mm. plated one, and we can install it in there. We're just going to reverse the process that we started. Okay, now that we have the nozzle close to the heat block, now we're going to need the wrench installed again so that way we don't torque the throat and break it. There you go. That is how to replace the nozzle on your Artillery 3D Sidewinder X1 3D printer. Now when it comes time to tightening it in there, don't go manhandling it in there, just gently tighten it up. If you're not sure about the tension, there is a 3D printable torque wrench that I will link to in the bottom, or if you happen to have access to a small torque wrench, I will give the approximate torque settings that people have determined gives the best results. And there we go. We now have our new MicroSwiss plated nozzle installed on the printer. Now, this nozzle might be slightly longer, it might be slightly shorter. We don't know from the original. So when you're done with this, make sure to go back and double check your first layer height and your bed leveling, just in case the height is off, so that way you don't either gouge your build plate or have prints not stick. Hope you guys found that useful, and I'll see you here next time on Make It With Calvin.